Hey guys, Willie here. Excited to bring you today's video. A lot of YouTube comments recently have been asking me to show you guys a game where I fall behind early. So here's a game where I'm jungling against Shaco, and Shaco takes my blue and my Gromp level 1. Here's how to path into cheese and how to play from behind. At the end of the game, I think we have double his CS and we're like 2 levels higher than him. So this is a really good game to show. Number 1, how to play from behind, but number 2, how to deal with cheese. So enjoy, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the future.
Dang! Call me so I can make it juicy for
ya. I saw on one of your VODs you were talking about sales and the importance of sales. Do you have any books or anything to learn up on it? Honestly, there's a million sales books out there. I would just say, like, honestly, this is going to be, it's tough advice, but it would be my best advice, is save up, get some savings accrued, and then go into a 100% commission sales role and just learn the ropes from people who are already doing it. That would be my advice. Reason being is sales is honestly one of the hardest jobs, but it's kind of like poker. Like, if you don't play with real money on the line, it's hard to do. And if you get a job with like a 30,000, 40,000 base plus commissions, you're going to be always somewhat comfortable. When you're in an environment where, like, I don't sell something, I don't eat, it really forces you to learn quickly. And you start implementing stuff way sooner. You have no patience. You get super aggressive, you know what I mean? Like, in terms of what you look for. So there are books I could recommend to you, but in terms of what you could do, I think with sales, the biggest thing is just learn from people that are doing it. So, like, literally go to somebody that's making a ton of money, like, whatever they're doing, solar sales, like, software sales, insurance sales, investment banking is essentially sales. You're convincing clients to work with you and invest with you, right? Like, anybody that's successful, just ask them for, just watch their shoulder for a day. Ask for a ride along. There's not a successful person I know that will tell you no if you say, hey, can I just watch you go to an appointment and pitch a client? Just say, like, you know, they love the opportunity to teach, and they also, it's a huge boost when you get to walk into the appointment and say, hey, this is my intern. He's trying to learn from me because I'm pretty good at what I do. I'm excited to talk to you today to learn more about your problems. It gives you instant credibility, like you're the hot dog in the room. You know what I mean? And the intern just gets to learn and see how to speak to people, and the client feel, or the prospect or the client feels, feels important. They're like, ooh, Shaco did such a cheese clear path. He was trying to go for my blue. So the good news is this clear path never works. The red over to blue Gromp thing, it's literally like season 6. I do this only when I'm smurfing. The reason being is it sets up my clear path a lot better than his. So I'm going to get full intel on him. I'll be able to tell you exactly where he started. Looks like he did red straight over to blue Gromp, which is fine. We're going to double check his Krug, see if we can take it. If not, we just go do crabs and reset. Reason why this clear path never works is, number one, it staggers his spawns. My clear, I'm a farmer. He's just a counter ganker. As we can see, he's here. He's literally sitting around doing nothing. I'm still on time for crab. The other thing that it tells me is he's got 16 CS, so he's done his red, his raptors, my blue, my Gromp. That's 16. 4 times 4 is 16. He has not done any of his topside camps yet, right? There's no reason for me to invade. We could try and fight him, but that's not the point of it. What we're going to do, though, is we are going to come over here. We're going to check top, and then we're going to come down here and fight him for this. So I really like this start against Shaco. Unfortunate, he wastes so much time doing that. You want to know, once again, why that's good? He did Raptors Red, Blue Gromp, which is just awful by all accounts for him. We're going to do this, and then we're going to eat our topside. Then we're going to reset, spend gold. Sucks that he gets the double crab, or the first crab, but hey, he wastes a ton of time. His level 1 camps are still on the map. Mine are respawning at level 4 and level 5. He is bleeding XP. You know, there's been a lot of YouTube comments. People want to see games where I fall behind early. This might be a good game for me to just show people how to path into cheese stuff. It's literally just path normally. Play smart, get your camps, spend gold optimally and efficiently, and then you'll be good to go. It's kind of the whole name of the game. We've got eyes on the Shaco. We know exactly what he's up to. We're going to go ahead and do this. How much can you sell the potion for? Like 20, you buy it for 30, get 20 gold back. I really like having Dark Seal. I think it's like required, so we're gonna get a Dark Seal. And then I think against Shaco, you want the red immediately. So, grubs are coming up in 20 seconds. I'm gonna go ahead and just farm my camps out. Since Shaco did take two camps away from me, he is gonna eventually pull ahead in CS if we don't stay on top of our camps. Hopefully he's not here right now. If he did my Gromp and then his ganking bot, we're in trouble. He didn't, so we're good to go. Honestly, I don't think they need me. Even if Shaco shows up, they win that 2v3, or that 3v3, I mean. Now, if Tristana starts roaming, we'd have to come over, but we're good for now. Now let's see if we can get the grubs. If Shaco's already there, they're going to be gone. Whatever. Whatever. He's had super weird pathing this game, so if it is gone, by all means, he passed super strange to get them. We do have Leona coming up, so I think we can get these no problem here. My topside camps are also coming back up, which is great for us. Let's see where the Shaco is. Shaco's mid. I think we can actually get a kill with Leona on this. Akshan is coming. We have to walk around this way. Shaco just got his cheeks clapped. Good knockback from the Tristana there. Good job keeping Seraphine alive by the enemy team. Okay, at this point, yes, I know bot crab's up. Don't care about it. We clear our topside, spend our gold. I think if we clear our full topside, let's count together. We start at 800 gold. Let's see where we end up. I'm just curious. I actually don't know these days. I'm trying to lock in like the fundamentals of jungle, you know what I mean? Like, how much is a topside quadrant worth? I think it's worth about 300 gold. But let's find out together. So, 800. A lot of things have changed since I've played the game. I know Krugs are usually worth about 130 gold. What we're going to do, we're going to make sure he doesn't get ganked here. We have no eyes on the Shaco. Does Aatrox have teleport? He does. Where would I be if I was Shaco? Bot? Bot. Great. Ganking bot is the answer. Take away his topside camps. You know the drill. He might take away my bot side camps, but it's okay. Let's see if we can go stop him. Sitting on a lot of gold, but I still don't have item. He's got a Tiamat and a longsword. I'm not really afraid of him. Great. Excellent. He didn't do the crab either, so we'll be able to get that. Let's get this off the map. So this is a great game to show. Look at the CS right now. 74 versus 48 CS. I missed my first blue and my first grump, but thankfully just Shaco has missed out on a lot of fundamentals this game of jungling. So we have caught up in farm now. We also just killed him there, so now he's blown all his tempo. We got a lot of good things going for us here. We've got the first round of grubs. We're going to reset here. We're going to do actually our wolves just so we can get it reset. Before you leave one quadrant, you always want to clear both camps if you can help it. What is up, Cole? Blazing Nut 420. Yo, Cole, I saw Gus yesterday. We had a cute little breakfast date. I was thinking about you, man. Gus might swing by. Today is Tuesday. He might swing by tomorrow if you're up for it. God, I'm so close to item, though. I'm so close to item. Look at this shit. Well, we found the Shaco. Shaco thinks he's outpathing me. Little does he know. We know exactly where he is right now. He just went over the wall, but that's fine. That's Shaco R. Always use Awaken R and choke points. Too much gold. That was my fault. Too much gold. I would love to see Leona pick that up with Ignite, if possible. We pick up 2 kills, it looks like. Leona should be able to finish that with enough CC. Nice. League of Leona, baby. That's so funny. Oh, I had a funny appointment today, Twitch chat. So I've got referral partners. I do health insurance for a living, right? I had a funny appointment. This guy, I told him I was a Twitch streamer, you know, and I get my thing. He told me this brilliant thing this other random guy does, right? He does hot sauce. So he does, like, mortgage, right? But he also has this brand of, like, hot sauce that he uses. But the reason he does it is he puts his branding and stuff on there. We're just going to wait for we win this fight, naturally, if people come. But the reason he does it is because you know how hot sauce bottles tend to stick in your fridge for forever, you know? So imagine if you put your branding like Willie Mortgage on a hot sauce bottle and then it just sits in your fridge for years and years and years and years and years. You're like, guess who you're going to call when you need a mortgage, you know? Nice. 6 grubs. The clone box might be the doom of me. Or is he AP? No, he's AD. You like the awakening through the Shaco boxes there? Great. Really, really good here. Really, really good. Shaco is so behind in farm, it is not even funny. And we get 6 stack grubs as red side of the map. A lot of good things this game. A lot of good things. Ooh, some Willy P pickles. Put the Willy P health insurance on a pickle jar. Just sit in someone's... It's like a flower or like... I'm trying to think of things that people never eat in their pantry, but they always have, you know? But like hot sauce is definitely up there. I got this New Orleans hot sauce that I absolutely love. I couldn't tell you the name of it, but it's delicious. It's this team comp. I think we have to go Mercs. Good old Shaco. Respawns, run straight bot, ganks, has all his camps on the map. Good old Shaco players, baby. Respawn, gank. Respawn, gank. Respawn, gank. To be fair, it's the only thing he can do. He's 2 levels behind me. Once again, in a game where he cheesed and started my blue and grump, he's 2 levels behind me. Listen, this little lane phase, what are you going to do when lane phase is over and you can't gank anymore and you got to fight level 10 Udyr, you know? Hope it works out. Oh, Hopefully that's enough with the burn. Great. Right before the thing. Let's get the tower too. Oh yeah. Taking Shaco to the cleaners on that one, dude. Put the burn on him. Get the burn on the real one. See exactly where he's going. Oh yeah, we know. We know the drill for Shaco, man. He went AD. I went AP because I know AD Udyr sucks into Shaco. We've got him unlocked this game. First two dragons. All six grubs. We're doing all right here. Strange Cloud, you're a real one. Hot Sauce goes pretty quick for me, though. Usually it takes me, like, I don't know, a month or two to get through it. I put hot sauce on everything. Burgers, tacos, rice. Yeah, we love hot sauce around here, especially if it's good hot sauce. He's ganking level 9 Shaco is ganking level 12. Who else is in the bush down there? We want to get the tower off the map if possible. The entire reason we're here, we're holding on to Awakening. Great, Shaco's on the camp. Shaco's dead? What? What happened to Shaco got executed on the Gromp? What a dummy. Look at this guy. Executed Twitch chat. Because he's too low of a level and took too much damage. Get this. Name of the game, keep him out of the game. Oh, Shaco's back, everybody, and he's with the Vengeance. Remember when he invaded me level 1 and took my blue buff? I do. If I need a flash out there. I've got too much gold on my head. And I got Dark Seal stacks. Not about it. Not about it, okay? Alright, GG, everybody. Oh, man. Pathing matters. I don't care what anybody says. 146 CS, 91 to CS. To 91, you know? Big brain jungler versus cheese jungler. Great. Funny part is, I haven't even cleared my bot side. I'm literally just clearing Shaco's top side and then my top side and just leaving it at that. Other than Seraphine, mostly AD. Oh, Varus went AD here? Okay, great. I might go into a little, Warden is pretty good. We could get Zhonya's Twitch chat. That would be pretty funny versus them. Especially for Shaco boxes. Kill the clone, press Zhonya's. I think we're going to do Riftmaker, though, and then we'll get the this thing, and then... Yeah, let's just do that. This is the safest way to play it. We'll get a Mejai's once we get 10 stacks. I'm not really in a rush for more damage. I've got plenty of damage. NA Masters, dude. NA Masters is... I said it before and I'll say it again. My rank is a scam. Until I get the Grandmasters, I really don't think I'm good at the game. Like, it is insane to me how consistently bad the games are. Like, win or lose, I'm like, I don't feel good about this win. I don't feel good about this loss. I feel like somebody just Like, last game, we had a guy that just didn't play Talia, lock in Talia. Like, he's just learning the champ. I'm like, okay. I guess we lose. All right, on to the next. You know? Let's see if we can find anybody here. I think they're on it. There's a lot of people missing. Interesting, they're still top. They're really desperate, huh? This is why we love grubs. It prevents teasing, it prevents snowball, it prevents, like, all that stupid stuff you see. Because, like, we win the base race. We've got grubs and we've got Jinx, you know? We've got an Akshan getting the dragon. Like, they can't base race ever. Now, if they have grubs, it opens a whole lot of win conditions that they otherwise just don't have, you know? Holding on to Awakening because I know I'm going top here. This Shaco is starting to piss me off here. AP Udyr just clap Shaco if you don't know. It's not even close. Like, he can't get on the same screen as you type thing. Especially when he messes up in pathing. We can end the game. Yeah, I think we just go mid here and end the game, honestly. It would have been close, but I think we could have done it. Not trying to talk shit, like, I just hope the Shaco stops cheesing, because it's not how to win games as jungle. Like, it's so unreliable to do it. But he's Shaco, so I get it. If you have to play Shaco, you have to play a very specific way, but I even think a Shaco just full clearing is better than the other way around. Alright, I think we go back and spend the 4,000 gold. Alright, let's get that. I don't even know what we built last item here. I'm just gonna wait. We're gonna get Rabadons for sure. Have a little fun. What's your least favorite Udyr matchup in jungle? Oof. There's a lot. Lily and Kindred, probably. Lily and Kindred. I statistically have like a 40% win rate against those champions. They're just, I ban Kindred every game, and if someone locks in Lilia, I have to completely change my build. You have to go like Dead Man's second item. You have to usually take Phase Rush. It's tough. It's tough. I think Nidalee's pretty hard. A good Nidalee player can actually do very well against an Udyr player. But it's a skill matchup. There's really not that many good Nidalees on the server. Like, Tarzan is one of the only Nidalee players I know. There's another high elo Nidalee one trick, but outside of that, you never see a Nidalee. Graves is good if he knows how to path, but Graves has honestly been nerfed so hard that, you know, I don't even consider him that good. Wow. What a pub stomp, this one. GG. Oh, man, that was an excellent game to showcase. Listen, for all the YouTube people saying, hey, Willie, you never upload games where you fall behind early. I had feeding laners, and I lost my blue and Gromp level 1, and we still outpathed them and just won the game because of it. So this will be an excellent reminder to the YouTube crowd. Here's how to play. Here's how to play successfully when you get...
Dang! Call me so I can make it juicy for you.